Good afternoon. My name is Ewelina Olbasienty, and I would like to present economic analysis of the production of supercritical extract containing bioactive substances from poplar. The research was prepared with my colleague Mariusz Stolarski and Michał Krzyżaniak. We represent the Department of Genetics, Plant Breeding and Bioresource Engineering. Kazimierz Warmiński represents Department of Chemistry and we work at the Faculty of Agriculture and Forestry and Center for Bioeconomy and Renewable Energy at the University of Warmia and Mazury in Olsztyn, Poland. Edward Trój and Katarzyna Tyśkiewicz represents Łukasiewicz Research Network, New Chemical Synthesis Institute, Supercritical Extraction Department, and Michał Łuczyński represents company Kemprof from Olsztyn, Poland. The concept of biorefinery assumes the multi-product use of biomass for production of high-value product first, and then the energetic use of post-production residues. In addition to environmental reason for the validity of such concept, the profitability indexes for a project, for profitability assumption of project is very important. The main objective of the research was to assess the economic profitability of production, including the analysis of life cycle cost of the selected bioproduct value chain in terms of biorefinery. The biomass raw material selected for the research was poplar, harvested in a short rotation. The main bioproduct was dry extract from poplar lignocellulosic biomass. The post-extraction biomass was used to produce an energy co-product, pellet. The main bioproduct, supercritical dry extract, was obtained by supercritical extraction and is an innovative ingredient in high-value bioproduct, example veterinary ones with anti-inflammatory properties. The analysis covered the period of 20 years with discount rate 5%. The economic model included the production of biomass in over 5 hectares a year, the production of approximately 900 kilograms of extract and approximately 60 megagrams of pellets a year. The scope of the research covered following system boundaries. Subsystem 1, it was biomass production involved costs related to production of poplar biomass in an annual cycle, including the establishment of the plantation, fertilization, harvesting, and preparation of wood chips, and liquidation of the plantation. The next subsystem, it was biomass logistic, covered the cost of transport to the pretreatment plant and the cost of drying and grinding process, as well as cost of transport to subsystem 3. Subsystem 3, called biorefinery, include costs and revenues related to production of supercritical dry extract, as well as cost and revenues related to production of pellet. Use of product and end of life was out of the system boundaries. The results of the analysis was revenue, which can be obtained from production in a supercritical dry extract value chain from poplar. The analysis include determination of investment cost and operating cost and life cycle cost. The largest investment costs were related to purchase and it was 73%, and installation, and it was 22% of a supercritical extraction line. Establishment of the plantation, liquidation of the plantation mill, transport duty pelletizing line has small share in the capex. The largest operating cost were personnel, staff cost, and it was 59%, and cost of materials and utilities related to the supercritical extraction process, and it was 37%. Quite significant operation cost was raw material and other fixed cost. Cost of land tax, packaging, cost of energy, water and wastewater related to grinding, moisturing, drying, uploading, washing, removal of water, pelleting, transport has small share in OPEX. Next, the production profitability analysis was carried out and the break-even point for the production of poplar chips, supercritical dry extract and pellet was determined. For poplar chips and pellets, market selling price was adopted, and on this basis, investment profitability indexes such net present value, internal rate of return, profitability index, and discounted payback period were determined. While for supercritical dry extract, investment profitability indexes were determined assuming a margin of 10% from the break-even price. The sensitivity analysis showed that the price of main product, supercritical dry extract, has the highest influence on net present value. The highest price of the extract, the highest net present value. The same relation was observed for pellet price. Quite significant influence on net present value has staff cost, supercritical extraction line, and supercritical extraction process. The rest of the mentioned components has very low impact on change in net present value. The risk analysis conducted with a Monte Carlo simulation for adopted assumption allowed to confirm the profitability of the investment with over 70% probability. Moreover, the analysis showed that the price increase above the break-even point by 20% allowed to obtain for whole investment and production a discounted payback period of 10 years and internal rate of return of 8%. To conclude, I would like to say that product life cycle cost analysis included poplar biomass production, wood chips preparation, biomass drying and grinding, extract production and packaging. The post-extraction biomass was intended for the production of pellet, and the production and sales processes was included in the assumption of the whole economic model. The largest investment costs were related to purchase and installation of the supercritical extraction line. The largest operating costs were personnel cost and cost of materials and utilities related to the supercritical extraction process. The profitability of the investment was most sensitive to the price of the extract, personnel cost, the cost of extraction, extract production line, and the cost of production extracts and a bit the price of the pellet. Other elements has a marginal impact on the profitability of the investment. The sensitivity analysis showed that the price increase above the break-even point by 20% allowed to obtain discounted payback period of 10 years. The risk analysis for the adapted assumption allowed to confirm the profitability of the investment with over 70% probability. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your attention.